enjoy doing that for you. So I'd like to present 1983 for me.
Thank you.
If I had a Thank you. expressions down upon each other some gag gifts. And these are some things that are kind of special to them. Most of them I think you'll be able to understand after they explain them to you, what they are, the purpose behind them, what they mean. But they're kind of special to us. So presenting them are juniors Valerie Schultz and John Flynn.
Next year, Jim, since you're an expert.
expressions. We got you this little orange juice container, and every time you perform, you can use it.
At the beginning of the year, we had this one picnic, and We gave Steve the most important job, I mean, of this whole thing. If we didn't have this, we couldn't eat, and Steve got the bag of charcoal, so we got him this little bag of charcoal. He can bring to the next picture.
I guess
shoot, she was supposed to have like 25 pairs in her house. So Jamie, we went out to Kmart and bought a beautiful pair of shoes.
So we got them these two little pictures of each other, so when they go to Wayne Classic, they remember each
Jim Patakos. We had a very, very difficult time figuring out what to do for Jim. But after months and months of searching and searching, we finally found something big enough to keep your ego in when you come out.
Sunday night. At first we thought we had a Holiday Inn job. It was just so regular.
They
was my baby this year. That was a song I wanted to do for a long time. Slaved over writing it, lifting it from the record. It took me a long time to write the parts, took me a long time to write the piano part, took me a long time to choreograph. Well, not a long time, but it was a definite, really concentrated effort. But I didn't write the horn parts. I said, I'll write the horn parts because I thought we'll perform it in April. Well, haha, my husband's killing me, so don't ever do that again. So all of a sudden, we're going with the band, we're going away for a weekend, and I'm sitting there slaving, writing horn parts. So I barely got it for the guys before we were supposed to go. But we did it. We got into a bus, and we were fortunate enough to perform for the Illinois Association of Recreational Beavers. They shipped us out to Oregon, Illinois. We performed at this little holiday inn or something. It was very crowded. The band was kind of halfway in the hall. There was a ceiling that was low. Chandeliers we kept eating, but it was... It was also the day after District 7. Most of them had sung for 8 hours. It wasn't our finest hour, but it was a good one. But then we went back to the White Pines Ranch, right? And went into those two dorms rooms, and we were fortunate enough to have Mr. and Mrs. Brockway go along with us. And, guys, can we tell it? Mr. Brockway snored. What can I say? And it was so funny. We ladies, we were all up there, and we had a great time, and we were all, you know, I mean, even though some of us snored too late, right? But, and they were very nice, so it's just a little mumbling. And Jean Bradley said to me, she goes, oh, I don't know. She says, Harold snores. But hey, it was a lot of fun. It was the first time I started working on the musicians to really bring them into a part of us, to a part of our unity, to a part of our values. And that's what this has to do with, too. We were over a Sunday morning. So as a result, we had a devotional service, and it was just kind of friendly. We just kind of talked about values within the group, values as a person, and most all the group went. And this was our candle that we passed around, and we made little wishes for the group and little hopes for each other. So that's why it is representative here with me as well. December, boy, there's 1 week. We started out at the Hamilton. We were lucky enough to get to sing in the Hamilton Bowls in front of, right in front of the food tables. People had to walk through us to get the chocolate mousse. You remember that? They were walking around with their spatulas. Two people we tracked there. We started doing the opening number, and they were standing there with their plates for vegetables right there by the table. We were going, oh my gosh, but they did survive. They waited for the whole first number plot and nicely went back to the stage. But we got to eat, so that was on Monday. Then on, that was on Sunday. Then on Tuesday, we went down to the Palmer House and performed for the Illinois Farm Bureau State Convention, which we'd also performed for the year before for their women's division. This time we got to perform for the men for the entire convention, which was about 2,500 people. It was really fun to get to go in there, you know, ride in like the stars, get to perform. People received us very well, although we had to stand around and wait a long time. And then it was about 11 o'clock at night, and we walk out, and our bus did not work. Remember that? That was also the night that we had to carry Kathy out, because Kathy started her little illness, so for that, you remember the Palmer House Mansion Fund. The next day we went to the King Home, which is a place in Evanston, which is the neatest home for elderly men. And they come down every day, they dress in ties and sport coats, and we got to have lunch with them that day, as well as perform with them. So all the kids were spread around, sharing the table with the gentlemen, and having a nice time, and cheering them up, as well as performing. On Friday, we performed at the First Presbyterian Church. Remember in the chapel, they had really good acoustics, like Michael and Johnny came along with us to watch us and help us. And then on the next Sunday was the chorus concert. And then, 1 week after that, was our Christmas show. And Brian joined our staff at that time. On his we had to turn people away. It was staying only. We had to, the house was packed. What a neat experience and a neat tribute to you. And people that came home from, that were at their colleges and came home and shared that day with us. We appreciate it very much. Then we come to March 10th. And I'm going to just take a moment to just talk to you a little bit about that. Just reminisce with us very shortly. We practiced hard for a couple of months, and I was very strict with them. I was very strict with the band, I was very strict with everyone. Because as a director, I don't know how many of you know this, but I go out as a guest clinician. I go out and give workshops
I go out and judge places, I go out and do freelance choreographies, doing the kind of things that I do here. And I have very often given trophies away to first place winning show choirs. And it was nice to be the expert, to be the person up there giving the lecture, to be saying, yes, I scored you, and yes, give positive comments, but I've always wondered what it would be like to be on the other side of the handshake. And that, I guess, was one of the neatest thrills of my life, is because as a professional, I always said, you know, I work hard at home, and then I go out, and people see me for a couple of hours, and they say, oh, she's interesting, or she's enthusiastic, I wonder what her group's like. And I always wanted to do, and say, wow, you know, the things I work for, the values are really as strong as what I hope they are. We got in a bus on March 9th, and we traveled, and everything was fine. And we went there, and we saw a couple of groups, and we were a little scared, but we were okay. The next morning, we went and saw some more groups. We were okay. We went back to the hotel, and we were still kind of okay, but kind of quiet. It was really cute, though. We had about 2 hours, and I'd asked, we had two great sets of parents that went along with us, Mr. and Mrs. Brackley and Mr. and Mrs. Drafts. And again, the things that were really important to me are the details, and so all the shoes had to be polished. So we looked like the little Santa's elves, because all the kids, before they went down to lunch, set all the little shoes on. Mrs. Brackley and Mrs. Drafts gave them a little bumpy. So that it was that kind of thing. I don't know if the audience or the judges would even notice it, but it was the fact that we knew it. We knew that down to that minute's detail, that was what was important to us, and that was fun too. And then Jim walked into my room and forgot his music. I convinced him, right, Jim? I said, leave the room. And then I said, come back. And then I sat on the radiator. I'm sorry. I sat on the radiator. I could not raise my voice at all. People kept walking by the room going, what is she going to do? And then I said to my husband, Jim into me. So Jim came in and I said, how much do you think you remember? What do you think you're going to do? This is life, you know, what do you can't make a piece of music appear that's not going to appear. And Jim swears that was the little edge that really helped us hold together was that little uncertainty that he didn't have his music along. Whether it was that or whatever. We got all dressed, we were all set to go, and we got in the bus. We're driving on away from the competition. We're about an hour ahead of the competition time. We thought we would sing in the bus. It was dreadful. I panicked. I just went, stop singing. Couldn't sing it. Key. Tried to sing Sweet George Brown, which is a cappella number. We should have been able to sing it just fine. It was just terrible. I just couldn't sing. Okay. So, now we get into there. Aside from the fact that there's all kinds of psychological things going on, because I judged this competition 2 years ago, and these people were really kind of gunning for us. But we were always very positive. Remember how the group from Minnesota came in and there was no one else in the audience that knew it? 35 of us cheered them on. So people really had a good feeling about Buffalo Grove. How was it? How was it done? Heidi's. So we had a great attitude going into it. We were a little scared. People kept walking in to look at us in the warm up room, like, psych out the competition. Awesome, awesome. You know, check it out. But we just kind of did our thing, right? Okay, so then we got out on stage. We talked a little bit about it. We had a circle before, and we went and said, let's just do it our best. And as I said, we will go make a statement. Whether they like our statement or not, we can't say it. But what we're going to do our very best. And we did. We went out there and performed. We were very well received. And when we got off stage, so many, I mean, in our faces and everything, we didn't care if we won because we knew we did our very best. It was so fun to be out there and do that. So we changed our clothes, listened to some groups for about another 3 hours. Our spirits went, we got tired too. Then we went to the place that they were going to announce the winners. Okay, it was a huge gymnasium. The judges were about half an hour late in coming. We were just lower than low. We were just mellow. Everybody kept saying, oh, you know, you can place it all, you're fine. You know, hey, it's the first time. I remember Sherry, the main cheerleader, now come on, it's great, you know, it's great. Okay. And so that's how we felt. And then the music came on, beat it. And Brian Lee's out there doing his breakdance and he's flipping across the floor. And it was just super. Everybody just lightened up and suddenly then it broke the tension and it wasn't so tense whenever they came to the announcements. Well, sort of not so tense. So they had announced there were six different classes. Class junior high, C, B, A, double A, triple A. We were triple A, the largest schools. So of course they start with the C's and go all the way up to the triple A's. We are still sitting there. I think Mr. Drafts, Ron Drafts, was the only one. He never lost the thing. Some of the rest of us just said, hey, it's in someone else's hands.
said that, and we'll take whatever happens. So we sat there and listened to the third place winner. And that was one of the groups that we had seen that we were concerned about, one of the local groups. And then the man who had kind of been really trying to psych me out, whose group we had not seen, they received second. And Heidi was already screaming. And I just said, I was sitting next to Jeff and I said, you know, in a couple minutes I may have to walk down there and I don't know if I'm going to be able to do that. There's this huge gym, it's all full of people, I'm sitting here with my babies and I don't know if I'm going to be able to do that. So then Rich, who was someone I knew, the contest person, said, a group, the first time they've ever performed here at Co College. My head dropped, Heidi's still screaming. And we all started to cry, and then they said, Buffalo Grove, and they all knew where we were sitting, because our jackets were always very visible. And so I just kind of dropped my head, squeezed Jeff's hand, and then I went down there. And just to walk down there, and it was okay receiving and shaking their hand and everything, but then looking back at your faces from the floor of the gym, and just seeing them, the smiles. And then we had to perform, okay? Because we received the honor. Not only did we win our class, but we won all classes. We were the highest level compared to any other classes of 56 schools. So we had approximately an hour to get together, put our clothes back on. We walked over to this gymnasium, sad, it was cold. When we walked back, it was five abreast with expressions in Buffalo Grove jackets, and it wasn't cold at all. We got in those costumes, we had one brush, we couldn't even find it, our hair was just wet. And here, the curtain is all ready to go up, and Mike and Steve don't have their ties on. And they're introducing us, and I'm staring right at them, and I'm going, your ties are working.
Thank you.
We're performing at the Orrington Hotel for some national convention at Orrington Hotel in Evanston on June 8th, as well as performing at St. Joseph's, where Mrs. Strass plays it Thursday afternoon. And then we have the distinct privilege, which we are really excited about, to perform at 7:30 at Arlington Park the night of the fireworks. So we are one of the warm-up acts to the fireworks, so we are looking forward to that much. I need those. I need that. There are a couple of things that we would like to, special people that we would like to recognize and thank very much for their efforts this year. And the first one is really from the entire choral department, not specifically from the expressions. And it's to a man that has been extremely supportive of all of us for all of our years, my 11 years here, and all of your years too, who is very special and who we miss greatly. Dr. Miller, would you please come?
It's a tremendous educational and social experience for them. Best of luck to you in the future.
Talk to them tonight, but I'll do the best I can.
I did this one. Okay, you can have two. Okay, scared me. Thank you for the most rewarding, the most important year of my life. Thank you for believing in me and the things that were important to someone who's my age, coming from someone who's your age. That meant more to me than any of that. For you to accept the vision that was in my eyes, for you to let me take you where I did. What I want to say to you is that the only reason you're sad is because you were so happy. If it hadn't been such a beautiful year, you wouldn't feel so bad about missing it so much. And if you hadn't had so many good times, you wouldn't be feeling the pain that you're feeling right now. So, enjoy. Guys, I don't need to upset you. But you are the best thing that's ever happened to Jeff and I. And you have brightened our lives. And I don't want you to think that we have been without our problems, but we faced everything with openness and honesty, and we conquered anything that came to our way, whether it be jealousies amongst ourselves, personality conflicts, men, women, love affairs, whatever. We always dealt with it. We were very honest. We faced up to it as a family does, and we conquered it. And that's what really makes you special. I've had dreams before that have just been fantastic on stage, but I've never had one like you off stage. I've never had one that's been so warm. It's such a treat to put in all the hours that we do. And I've never had one that appreciated me as much. That limo was a real hit. Because I guess, let's face it, we think we're kind of special in what we take the time to do. And I'm not training musicians the next day, but I'm training young men and women that'll learn to work together, learn to be responsible, and accepting adults. And I am so proud of you. I remember when we got together in the fall, I was, wow, do you think we'll gel together? And I'm just so proud to be your director. Part of you and what you have become. So, it's not goodbye. It's not. Remember, Sharon told us it. It's not. Things will be different. That's true. But it's not goodbye. The only thing that will change, maybe you won't wear blue fuchsia dresses and black suits. But that's only the outside covering. The bonds that you've created is what's on the inside. And that's not going to change. And that's going to stay there. Thanks to the people that helped to make that all possible. I'd like to present to you Senior Award. Outstanding seniors in this group, as always. And they have given so much to the organization through their leadership, their talents, and everything. I can't thank you all enough for me being able to holler at you or respond and say, okay, maybe you didn't agree with everything I did, but you always accepted it. And you said, okay, I'll give her a chance. You are with okay results. Expressions motives, they selected for themselves the person that they feel is the outstanding expression. And I agree that many, many people could have gotten this award, but this was really well received. And I present it to you.
Thank you.
wonderful men that talked with us and gave us so much excitement on stage. And we really couldn't have done it without you. You added so much to everything that we did. And we're so grateful and so much fun. I thank you for taking all those dots that I wrote and making them into music. And we all have a great deal of thanks to our
Thank you.